Hello, check. Check, check, check. Hello, check.
Which table? Which that table? Okay. Touch it, man, see if it's coming again.
Just speak on the mic. Oh, just speak on the mic once.
check, hello, check, 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 check,
hello, check.
Hello? Praise the Lord.
No. Maybe I didn't. Maybe I think you'll have to disconnect. Baby. Listen. I think just check if the Bluetooth is still connected. It might send on the Bluetooth. So disconnect the Bluetooth if you're connecting cable. Check the volume.
I'll do that. For entrance, kindly take hymn number 211 into your hands.
Into your hands, we commend our spirit, O Lord. Into your hands, we commend our
In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My dear brothers and sisters, as we journey through life, there is always a first time and a last time. And in my relationship with Gladys Depena, I had a first time encounter with her when I was first appointed here as parish priest 6 years ago. And my last time with Gladys was on Tuesday. After the evening mass, I sat down on a chair since I cannot stand for longer as I've just come back from hospital. And it was that time, at that moment, Joyce brought Gladys to me, and this is the last conversation she had with me. Father, I prayed and prayed and prayed for you, that you may return back to the parish, and I'm so happy that you have come back. And I will continue to pray for you. And you know, Father, I was traveling back from Pune to Bombay with my sister-in-law. And I was praying very hard that I must reach back to Amboli to witness the musical Cindy. And you know, Father, God heard my prayer. I just came in the nick of time, freshened myself, and I went and witnessed the musical Cindy. Father, I was so happy that I could witness this musical. What a beautiful message. And then again, she said, Father, I will continue to pray for you that you may have good health and you may continue to serve us. And there was a pause of silence, and both of them, Joyce and Gladys, went back to their homes. As I talk to you today on our funeral day, I know that I personally have an angel in heaven, a star in heaven, who will pray for me. Because my last encounter with her, she said, Father, I will pray for you. So I'm sure she will pray for me, even if she's not on earth, if she's in heaven with our Father. What I know about Gladys is this. She has been a very dedicated and committed wife. She looked after her ailing husband with so much of care, love, and concern. She was a very committed mother to her two sons, Gabriel and Michael. It was Vicky Santos who told me that, Father, Michael's mummy is very serious. And I couldn't believe it. Just on Tuesday, I had a last encounter with her. And then, Wednesday night, we were at table. And once again, Vicky phoned me saying that Gladys is no more. And I screamed on top of my voice saying, what? And then Leon added, Father, I've just come back from a sick call. When you were sitting down there, I went for a sick call. What a beautiful impression Gladys has left before leaving the parish of St.Blaise, Amboli. And I'm sure she will be there with us at all times, not only with her family, but also with us parish fathers. Whenever she sends something to the parish fathers, she sends huge hampers. And when I meet her, I would say, what big hamper did you send? No, Father, that is so little for so many of you. But that was Gladys. And this morning I met this Tom, Dick and Harry, and they are all in praise about Gladys. So my dear brothers and sisters, with sadness in our hearts, with pain, we are here to give our mother, our sister, our parishioner back to the Lord. And we do it with joy, because her physical body will not be with us, but she will always stay with us forever and ever. Let's pause for a little while and thank Gladys for a relationship with a number of people here at St. Blaise, Amboli. And we pray for her family, her two sons, her husband, and her other son also, who died some years back, that God may grant them eternal rest. So let's close our eyes for a moment. And now let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Altogether, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. God Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that through this mystery, your servant Gladys, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Please be seated.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brethren, our citizenship is in heaven, and from it we await a Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ, who will transform our lowly bodies to be like his glorious body, by the power that enables him even to subject all things to himself. The word of the Lord.
For the psalm, take hymn number 388, The Lord is my shepherd.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures where he gives me repose. Near restful waters he leads me to revive my drooping spirit. There is nothing I shall want. He guides me along what he knows to be right. If I walk in the darkness, no evil would I fear. I know that he will be there with his crook and with his staff. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Yes, the Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
Rise for the gospel.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. At that time, Jesus said to his disciples, "Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many rooms. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, that where I am, you may be also. And you know the way to where I am going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ.
For offertory, kindly take hymn number 6-7. Blessed are you, Lord.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Thanks to your goodness, this bread we offer, fruit of the earth, work of our hands.
Through your goodness,
it will become the bread of life. Blessed be God, blessed be God, blessed be God forever. Amen. Blessed be God, blessed be God, blessed be God forever. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Thanks to your goodness, this wine we offer, fruit of the wine, work of our hands, it will become a cup of joy. Blessed be God, blessed be God, blessed be God forever. Amen. Blessed be God, blessed be God, blessed be God forever. Amen.
Please stand. Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we humbly present to you the sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Gladys, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful Judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as one alone he accepted death so that we might all escape from dying, as one man he chose to die so that in your sight we all might live forever. And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you and with joy we proclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, let the dew fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Cardinal Oswald Gracious our Archbishop and all the clergy. Remember Gladys, whom you have called from this life today, from the world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and bound by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other a meaningful sign of peace. Peace be with you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
The world, and that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life. In his time, in his time, he makes all things beautiful in his time. Lord, please show me every day as you're reaching me to that you do what you to say in his time. Your time, your time, you make all things beautiful in your time. Lord, my life to you I bring, may its song I have to sing be to you a lovely thing in your time. Lord, please show me every day as you're teaching me your way that you do just what you say in your time. Your time, in your time.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our sister Gladys may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Ecclesiastes chapter 3 verses 1 to 6. To everything there is a season, a time for every matter under heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to pluck what is planted, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to keep and a time to cast away. We are gathered here today, this evening, to celebrate the life of our precious mother, Gladys Depena, so that together we may acknowledge and share both our joy in the gift from God that her life was to us, and help ease the pain that her passing brings. In sharing the joy and the pain together today, may we lessen the pain and remember more clearly the joyful times we are grateful to God for. Mom was 73 years old when the Almighty God gathered her up in his arms yesterday, reuniting her to himself. It is hard to say goodbye, Mom, and we all wish we had much more time to spend together. Mommy, you've left a legacy of love and blessing by the way you've touched our lives, which will always remain with us forever. And I ask you to keep these memories alive by sharing them with each other. It was a joyous day in the Matthias family, and God gifted Mommy a beautiful and loving baby girl to Papa Peter and to Nana Phyllis Matthias. She was always in the middle of both her parents, holding on to both of them tightly. As a young lady, her days at YWCA Bombay were heartbreaking as she had to leave home, leave her parents, leave her siblings, and come all alone to Bombay at the age of 17, where she met Auntie Tekla, a lifelong friend at the YWCA. Mom spent many, many, many happy years with her parents, my late uncle Desmond, her sister Jennifer, and their families at Four Bungalows and then at Jageshwari. Professionally, she has dedicated 43 years of her life in a flourishing career at FDC and was immensely loved and admired by her management, colleagues, helpers, and friends. I am sure all the FDC family will vouch for that today. Mummy also met the love of her life, my dad, Iggy, a handsome, young, well-built officer at FDC. She spent 33 years with dad as a loving and devoted wife, caring for him before God embraced him in his loving arms. Mom was a devoted daughter and cared lovingly for Papa, Nana, Auntie Rose, and was also a devoted daughter-in-law. She cared for my paternal grandmother, Irene Depena. She was a loving, caring, kind mom to us, her three sons, and brought us up staunchly in the Catholic faith. Our very names, Anthony, Gabriel, and Michael, spell this out so clearly. My eldest brother, Baba Anthony, lighted up their lives, early married life, for a dazzling 4.5 heavenly months before God chose to call him back to heaven on the feast of Our Lady of Lourdes, 11th of Feb. We had a wonderful life growing up in a family till today. My wife, Rochelle, practically grew up in our home and spent many happy years with Mommy and Daddy through all the ups and downs of life. She loved my parents dearly and found mommy to be a fun-loving mother-in-law. We say a heartfelt thank you to Michael's fiancée, Dr. Susanna, who had been close to mommy in the past few months, and most importantly, rendered help, guidance and support in the crucial hours of mom's time in the hospital yesterday. Thank you very much, Susanna. My mommy was a wonderful homemaker and loved making sweets. Her famous bottle masala, which went all over the world. Bread pudding, wine, salted tongue, cakes, her Christmas sweets, and shared them with friends, neighbors, and families. She was an exemplary housewife and always made sure that her home was spick and span. We are also grateful to our house elves, especially Teresa, Nirmala, Merun, and all our other house elves who worked for her. They were like members to our family over the years and a huge support to her. In the closing, we give thanks to God for the gift of our beloved mother, her guardian angel, archangels, and patron saints who cared for her life on earth and have now returned with her in the triumph to the arms of our Lord. I say salute to you, mommy, for bringing us up and making us what we are today. You and Dad have been exemplary pillars of strength to us. Eternal rest grant unto Mama Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. May her soul rest in peace. Amen. And may the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. The Month's Mind Mass will be held on 8th of March at 7 p.m. in St.Blaise Church, Amboli. Michael would like to say a few words.
My first love, my ever-loving mama. You taught me the meaning of love and you taught me to love. Mama, I really have no words to express, but I want to tell you that I love you. Mama came to Mumbai at a very early age from Bhusawal. She came here to study her secretarial course and worked hard and became the first lady officer of her beloved company, FDC. She worked there for 43 long years. Mama made four best friends there, Auntie Virginia, late Auntie Stella, Auntie Mavis, and Auntie Fatima. And their friendship holds strong till date. She met my dada at FDC and got married in 1989 to him. Mama spent 33 long years with dada. She loved him dearly, and so did Dada love her. She loved him and pampered him even during his 13 years of illness and always cared for him. Mama had a first child, Baba Anthony, but God took him in 4.5 months. Mama, you were broken but strong, and God gave you the strength and courage. You then had Gabriel and then me. Mama, you are the strongest woman I have ever met and been with in my life. You looked after your mother and she lived happily till 102. You had a caring hand. Alongside a sick husband for 13 years and also balanced nurturing Gabriel and me with good values, education, culture and respect. Mama was so strong, she underwent both her knee replacements. And then almost a year later, she had a fall. She then underwent a hip replacement. She fought that too and was back on her feet walking. She was indeed a warrior. She went walking to church daily after that. Mama had 11 dental implants at her age of 70. She was really brave. Around 6 months ago, she got both her eyes operated for cataract. After so many surgeries, she was fit and fine. Looking at Mama, no one would ever say she had so many surgeries. She was a source of strength and courage to all. Mama, you were the most generous, caring, and loving person. Mama taught me to always let go of past mistakes and look ahead. She was very forgiving in nature. She taught me to be brave and courageous, just like her. She was entrepreneurial and very enterprising in spirit. Mummy loved to cook, bake. She was very particular about neatness and cleanliness and tidiness. Mummy liked reading, poetry, and writing. And she kept in touch with all her friends, colleagues, and family in through WhatsApp daily. She really loved Gabriel, Rochelle, me, and Susanna. Mama, you were my best friend and mentor. You knew every secret of mine and always encouraged and motivated me and always taught me to think, dream, and aspire big always, to persevere and never lose hope. Mama was very prayerful and attended daily Mass. She always told us to keep faith in the Lord Almighty. When my dad passed away on the 16th of November 2022, 11 days later was my brother's wedding. Mom was broken, but she stood strong for us and the family and helped us make the wedding a grand success. Mama was overwhelmed to meet my wife-to-be, Susanna, and was overexcited to sign witness for our marriage and said, "Dolly girl, don't worry, I am there for you all." Indeed, Mama, you went too soon, but I know you will live in our hearts forever, and I know you will be there blessing us on our marriage along with Dada. Mama, you may not be physically present, but you will continue to live in our hearts forever. Indeed, you touch so many lives through your kindness, love, and generosity. Mama, I can go on and on, but it now gives me peace that you are reunited with Dada. We thank all the doctors, nurses, medical staff, relatives and friends, and especially Father Adrian, who has supported us and stood by us in this time. Mama, I want to tell you, I'm sorry if I've ever hurt you. I love you the most and you meant the world to me. Finally, goodbyes are not forever, goodbyes are not the end. They simply mean I'll miss you until we meet again. Thank you.
Please stand. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Go forth, the Mass is ended.
For the sessional, kindly take hymn number 282.
With faith in Jesus Christ, we reverently bring the body of our sister Gladys to be buried in his human imperfection. Let us pray with confidence to God, who gives life to all things, that he will raise up this mortal body to the perfection and the company of the saints. May God give her a merciful judgment and forgive all her sins. May Christ the Good Shepherd lead her safely home to be at peace with God our Father. And may she be happy forever with all the saints in the presence of the eternal King. Let's maintain a few moments of silence and pray for the repose of her soul, as the body will now be sprinkled and incensed. Our response will now be, receive her soul and present it to God the Most High. Please repeat, receive her soul and present it to God the Most High. Saints of God, come to our aid, come to meet her, angels of the Lord. Our response, May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to Abraham's side. Our response. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. Father, into your hands we commend our sister Gladys. We are confident that with all who have died in Christ, she will be raised to life on the last day and live with Christ forever. We thank you for all the blessings you gave her in this life to show your fatherly care for all of us and the fellowship which is ours with the saints in Jesus Christ. Lord, hear our prayer. Welcome our sister Gladys to paradise and help us to comfort each other with the assurance of our faith until we all meet in Christ to be with you and with our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. We will now proceed to the cemetery for burial.
For recessional, kindly take hymn number 282, Nearer My God.
In though it be a cross.
father's waiting there. They'll get the body there. Wait, father's coming. Sister Gladys from this life to herself, himself, the public is born, rise from the cross to rise from the dead, and we know that we will raise up our bodies to be like this in glory. We commend our sister Gladys to the Lord, that the Lord receive her in his peace and grace of the body and the life. Let us pray for our sister Gladys, for our Lord Jesus Christ, and the resurrection of the life, and the believes in me, the living with his eyes. And every living person who puts his faith in me will never suffer each other. Our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, you wept in the death of Lazarus, comfort us in our sorrow. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
You raise the dead to life, give our sister Gladys eternal life. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
You promise power of the thief will repent. Bring our sister the joys of heaven. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our sister Gladys was washed clean in baptism and anointed the oil of salvation. You have fellowship with all your saints. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
She was nourished with the body and blood, granted a place in the table of the Lord in the kingdom. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Comfort us in our sorrow and death of our sister Gladys. With our faith, we have consolation and eternal life for her. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We shall now recite the Our Father.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
Listen, prayers for our sister Gladys. As she always desired to do your will, so in your mercy forgive whatever wrong she may have done. By your Christian faith, we united with your believing people. Now in your loving mercy, give us the angels and saints. Thank you.
Thank you. Amen.